Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's time for another episode of Sam Arcade. Today we are diving in the world of Arch Linux installation. Unlike other distros, Arch Linux provides a hands-on experience, allowing you to build your system from scratch. If you guys don't know, I recently made a video on Arch ISO. Make sure to check that video out after watching this one. Link is in the video's description. What this tool does is actually allow you to build your own custom Arch ISO with tools and configuration of your liking. And today I am going to demonstrate to all of you how to install Arch Linux manually with your own custom Arch Live ISO build. Using the manual installation method with a custom Arch ISO, you guys will notice a drastic change in the speed of manual installation process of Arch Linux. After booting the custom Arch Live ISO, you guys can do anything you want in the Arch Live ISO, like use a browser to browse the internet or check the Arch Linux wiki to better understand the manual installation process. It all depends on you. So let's get started. For demonstration purpose, I'm installing Arch Linux inside the Work Manager. And you can follow my VM's configuration if you want to install Arch Linux inside the Work Manager. The installation process for Arch Linux is the same as the actual hardware installation. Now I am going to create a new virtual machine, and for proof that I am using a custom Arch ISO that I recently built, I am going to use this ISO to install Arch Linux in this VM. And this installation will show you the UEFI installation method with the 3D acceleration enabled in it. I am going to allocate RAM about 5 GB, and CPU cores will be half of my system CPU cores. For disk space, I am going with 80 GB. Remember, do not forget to select the UEFI BIOS. In the Spice tab, select the OpenGL, then toggle Listen Type to None. In the Video over I/O tab, you can select 3D Acceleration if you want. Remember, this will impact your performance. That's it. Now let's begin the installation. And we are inside our live environment. First, we need to check the internet. You can use ping command to check your network's status. The network is working fine. LSBLK lists information about blocked devices. We will use the LSBLK command from time to time, so remember this command. We need to manually partition our drives. Let's use the cfdisk command to create our partitions. For partition table, I am going with GPT, and EFI partition will be 512 MB, and the rest will be root partition. Swap partition totally depends on you. Now let's manually format our drive partitions. First, let's format our root partition into ext4, which is going to be /dev/vda2. Now we are going to format the boot partition into FAT32, and that's going to be /dev/vda1. It's time to mount the root partition, and we are going to mount it into /mnt. The /boot/efi directory doesn't exist, so let's make it first. Then it is going to be mounted into /mnt/boot/efi directory. As you can see, all three partitions are activated appropriately. We will use the packstrap command to download the essential packages, which includes base, Linux, Linux-firmware, and to compile stuff we need base devel, soft firmware for sound cards, grub, EFI boot MGR, and network manager for boot and network, nano for text editing, USB utils for commands like LSUSB, NTFS 3G and XFAT utils are for XFAT and NTFS partition support. Now we are going to generate the file system tab. To check that our file system tab file is generated properly, we can use the cat command to see the fstab file. It's time to change root to our installed system. And we are in our system. Arch Linux allows us to choose from various locales. We can uncomment the desired locale in the locale.gen file. Regenerated using the locale-gen command. We want to specify our locale in /etc/locale.conf because some programs might need it. Now we are going to set up our time zone. HWClock --sys2sc is to synchronize the system clock. Just do a simple Google search and you will get your time zone. Now we are going to specify the host name and set its root password. It is time to map hosts to IP addresses on the local system. Replace Sam with your host name. To add a new user to your system, use the command /usr add -m -capital G -s/bin/bash username and hit enter. Then to set its password, use passwd space username. Now we are going to edit the sudoers file. Uncomment the wheel group option. It's time to install Grub on the drive where we install our OS, and then we will configure Grub. Then we will enable the network manager for mapping our networks. So systemctl enable network manager. It is time to exit the root and unmount the /mnt directory. Just run reboot command and wait until your OS boots. Now log in with your username and password that we set before. Use sudo su command to switch to the root user. It is time to install the display manager, display server and desktop environment with some essential packages. The next step is to start our display manager. To enable the display manager, use the systemctl enable sddm command, and now we reboot. As you can see, our system is working properly. We have KDE Plasma, Dolphin, GNU, Firefox, etc. One last step is to install and run NeoFetch. That's it for today's video. Make sure to hit like button and subscribe to my channel so you never miss out my latest videos. And if you have any kind of feedback or suggestion, then feel free to leave a comment. Thanks for watching.